If there's anywhere in the world where the demographic dividend is going to prove important, it's sub-Saharan Africa. Between 2012 and 2050, the population of sub-Saharan Africa is roughly expected to double. On a yearly basis, if you consider individuals between the ages of 15 and 64, their numbers are expected to go up on a yearly basis, on average, by 3.5%. The dependency ratio can be expected to make a very large shift. So as of 2012, there are roughly 6 people working for 5 people not working in sub-Saharan Africa. By the time 2050 comes around, we can expect that ratio to be almost 2-1. That is, 2 people working for every 1 person not working. The good news, of course, is that a lot more young people means a lot more people working. This makes it easier to increase output, and this kind of so-called demographic dividend has driven economic booms in parts of the world as diverse as East Asia and also Ireland. Having a large number of working people also makes it easier to support the very old and to support the very young. The obvious question, of course, is what will all of these people do for jobs? For an optimistic perspective on this matter, consider the work of Alwyn Young. Alwyn Young went back and looked at the numbers on Africa, and he decided that other economists have been underestimating the rate of African growth. A typical estimate is that the continent of Africa has been growing at about 1% a year, and indeed those are the numbers shown by national income statistics. Alwyn Young looks instead at numbers on consumption, how people are spending their money. He looks at ownership of durables, housing conditions, children's nutrition and health, and household time and family economics. His conclusion is that on average, sub-Saharan Africa has been growing at a rate of about 3.3%. Of course, that's much better news. In this view, much of sub-Saharan Africa has a rising middle class, rising service sectors, and rising cities and urbanization, and that all of these developments taken together will in fact put most of these young people to work and in a very productive manner. Africa can expect a kind of demographic dividend to help spur its growth. Again, that's the optimistic perspective. For a more pessimistic perspective, consider the work of Peter Lipton. Here's what Lipton wrote, quote, "Stop kidding ourselves. Faster GDP growth in Africa since 2000 is mainly a mining boom with dubious benefits. Staples yields and labor productivity have not reversed the dismal trends that Peter Timmer diagnosed 2 decades ago. Big, credible rises are seen in only a few African countries, for instance, Rwanda, Ghana. The populous ones, Ethiopia, Nigeria, maybe Kenya, above all DR Congo, tell a sad tale." End quote. In Lipton's view, what many people are calling a demographic dividend, in fact, has the potential to be a demographic disaster. There will be many more young people, but not necessarily very productive ways of employing them. This remains very much an open debate, and of course, the right answer may depend upon exactly which countries you're looking at. For more reading on these and related issues, see the references given here.